Music is everywhere.
Part A. Hearing music everywhere.
In the courts of kings. And in the great cathedrals. At country dances. In private homes. And on city sidewalks. Music has always been present in people's lives.
In fact, it is said that music originates out of life itself and portrays every side of human experience. Because music expresses feelings that are hard to put into words, it is sometimes called the language of the emotions.
Music is a way of sharing feelings. It is natural, for example, for people to want to voice their love for their homeland. In national anthems, in patriotic songs, and even in classical works, music can speak for an entire people.
Finland's great composer, Jean Sibelius, wrote eloquently of his country in the symphonic poem, Finlandia.
Listen to the prayer-like melody played by the strings. It has become a national anthem in Finland. Later in the piece, this melody returns louder and stronger, as if to show the determination of the Finnish people to be independent. Music also offers a way to express negative feelings. The threat of nuclear warfare and America's involvement in Vietnam in the 1960s provoked passionate protests around the world. In the song Freedom, Richie Havens spoke for many young people of the time whose hopes for a peaceful world were being shattered.
Freedom, freedom, freedom. Sometimes I feel like a motherless child. Sometimes I feel like a motherless child. Sometimes I feel like a motherless child. Alone, away from my home.
The use of music as a means of open protest is the product of a democratic society, which is relatively new.
Music for religious or spiritual expression, however, is almost as old as man. It is one of mankind's earliest gifts to God, and often an inseparable part of religious ceremony.
In Catholic churches, Gregorian chants were used to celebrate Mass. Some of these date from the 6th century.
Johann Sebastian Bach composed religious music for the Protestant Church. Listen to his version of a hymn by Martin Luther, "A Mighty Fortress Is Our God."
Celebrations also inspire musical offerings, from birthdays to weddings. From football games to coronations, special occasions are not complete without music.
Perhaps you recognize this well-known work. You can hear it at many different special occasions. It is Pomp and Circumstance, written by the British composer Edward Elgar.
The familiar Wedding March by Felix Mendelssohn was written in the early 1800s at the request of King Frederick William IV of Prussia.
He wanted music to accompany the performance of William Shakespeare's comedy, A Midsummer Night's Dream.
George Frederick Handel wrote the Royal Fireworks music in 1749 to celebrate the end of the Seven Years' War. Although the original occasion is long past, the music survives to please us today. Thank you.
The 1812 Overture was written for the Tsar's Jubilee by Peter Ilyich Tchaikovsky. It was first performed out of doors at the dedication of a cathedral in Moscow. This rousing music has been used for many occasions. Music is especially popular at public events. Hearing a marching band at a parade, the throbbing beat of the drums, the majestic quality of the brasses, and the piercing sound of the woodwinds awakens emotions and lifts the spirit. Listen to John Philip Sousa's rousing march, Stars and Stripes Forever. It has stirred hearts and set feet tapping for over a century.
Perhaps most important of all, music is a way for people to express emotions or their deepest, most private feelings.
In this song by the Beatles, the words, lyrical melody, and string accompaniment are blended to express love for a woman.
Sergei Prokofiev captures the intense love that two young people feel for one another in his ballet, Romeo and Juliet. The strong emotion is expressed in the music.
People may also experience each other's sorrow through music. In the Erlkönig, or Elf King, Franz Schubert tells of a father riding through a storm with his sick child in his arms. According to German legend, the child must die because he has been touched by the king of the elves.
Ihr habt den kleinen Sohn.
The powerful message of universal brotherhood is expressed in the finale of Ludwig van Beethoven's Ninth Symphony. It is based on the poem Ode to Joy by the great German poet Friedrich von Schiller.
Did you know that until the 1870s, people had to be at a live performance of music in order to hear it? Music was not recorded until the invention of the record player by Thomas Alva Edison in 1877.
We are told that Jenny Lind was a great singer in the mid-1800s. People flocked to hear her concerts. But no one knows today how her voice sounded. The beauty of her voice disappeared forever when she died.
Now we can hear the singer and the musician even if we are not at the performance. In fact, even if the performer isn't there. People who have not yet been born will know how Louis Armstrong sounded. They will know how Paul Simon sang.
The mothers and the fathers and the automatic birds. These are the days of miracle and wonder. This is the long distance call. The way the camera follows us in slow-mo. The way we look to a song, oh yeah. The way we look to a distant constellation that's dying in a corner of the sky. These are the days of miracle and wonder. Don't cry, baby, don't cry, don't cry.
People will also know the voice of Luciano Pavarotti.
Today, more people can hear a greater variety of music at any one time than has ever been possible in the past. Anyone who wants to listen to music has a wide choice of music types and ways and places to hear it. Music is truly everywhere.
Thank you.
Music is everywhere.
Part B, Music's Many Meanings. Music is written to evoke different emotions or moods in the listener. A work may have been created to stimulate feelings of energy or serenity, foreboding or excitement, peace or turbulence.
Listen to Waltz of the Flowers from The Nutcracker by Peter Ilyich Tchaikovsky. The steady waltz rhythms and lyrical melody are lilting and cheerful.
Contrast this with the mood of Night on Bald Mountain by Modest Mussorgsky. The sudden changes in dynamics from loud to soft, the progressively higher notes played by the strings, and the rhythmic wind parts all create a sense of uneasiness. This music sounds spooky.
Air on a G-String by Johann Sebastian Bach has a serene and soothing quality. The pleasing harmonies are enhanced by the rich sounds of a string orchestra composed of violins, violas, cellos, and string bass.
Some compositions suggest a feeling of grandeur. In The Great Gate of Kiev, from Modest Mussorgsky's Pictures at an Exhibition, the timpani add to the brilliance of the brass section. This instrumentation conveys a sense of majesty. Now, listen to the second movement of Ludwig van Beethoven's Symphony No. 3. The Funeral March, written in a minor key, expresses sadness. The melody, played by the strings and later by the oboe, is accompanied by a repetitious pattern, or ostinato, performed by the string bass.
Some music creates a sense of excitement. Hoedown by Aaron Copland sets the mood for a special event with its syncopated rhythms, foot-tapping beats, and unexpected accents. ¶¶
Music that is meant to describe specific emotions, scenes, or events, or that tells a particular story, is called program music. The work is given some meaning that exists outside the music itself. Symphonie Fantastique by Hector Berlioz is an example of program music. It presents a series of dreams that trace the progress of a young musician's love for a woman. It is called a symphony because it is composed for orchestra and divided into several movements. The first of five movements, called Dreams, reveals the young musician's longing for his beloved. The dreamlike quality of quiet, slow-moving, long lines of melody are played by the strings. In the second movement, a ball, the musician is in the midst of a brilliant festival where he sees his beloved. The introduction by the lower strings and harp is made up of shimmering arpeggios or notes of a chord played quickly in succession. And is followed by a delightful waltz melody performed by the violins.
In the third movement, Scene in the Fields, the musician retreats to the countryside to overcome his feelings of rejection. At the beginning of this movement, the comforting sound of the English horn is answered by a distant oboe. This describes two shepherds calling their flocks. At the end of the movement, one shepherd's lone call is answered only by menacing thunder. This hints of the drama to come.
In the fourth movement, March to the Scaffold, the musician is to be executed for murdering his beloved. The repetitious rhythms in the timpani create tension and suspense. The timpani patterns become steadily louder and finally lead to a stately melody of descending notes performed by the cellos and string bass. In the final movement, Dream of a Witch's Sabbath, the musician dreams that he is present at a witch's revel. He is surrounded by horrible spirits who have come together for his funeral.
Unlike the program symphony, a symphonic poem, or tone poem, is a piece for orchestra in just one movement. Till Eulenspiegel's Merry Pranks, a symphonic poem by Richard Strauss, is about a folktale character in a small Belgian town. Till is a practical joker who does nasty things in a funny way. Listen as the instruments seem to laugh as he plays one of his typical pranks.
Program music may also illustrate a specific event or scene. In his work, Fourth of July, the American composer Charles Ives captures the feeling of the holiday in several ways. Through the dissonant or tense-sounding harmonies played by the orchestra, through the use of drum rolls, and through the piercing quality of the piano.
Notice how Ives uses and distorts a familiar melody.
Now listen to Winter, one of the four concertos that make up the Seasons by Antonio Vivaldi. Winter has three movements and follows the typical construction of the late Baroque concerto: fast, slow, fast. An Italian sonnet entitled Winter accompanies the concerto. Vivaldi communicates the poem's line, "And from such cold your teeth chatter," through certain instrumental techniques.
The dissonant harmonies played by the violin vividly depict the chattering effect.
Some composers are influenced by the sounds around them. Just as they might use musical instruments to copy specific sounds, they may include literal reproductions of environmental sounds in their compositions.
In The Typewriter by Leroy Anderson, an actual typewriter is played by a member of the percussion section. Anderson composed the sounds made by the typewriter.
Composers consider the unique tone qualities of each instrument to achieve special effects. Beethoven uses woodwind instruments to imitate the sounds of birds in his Sixth Symphony.
In The Planets by Gustav Holst, the music played by the celesta and the harps and the shimmering roll of the suspended cymbal suggest the great expanse of outer space.
The flute, played in its lower register, is used to create a dreamlike effect in Claude Debussy's Prelude to the Afternoon of a Faun. In this piece, the faun, a character from Greek mythology, awakens in the wood and tries to recall whether he actually saw three lovely nymphs passing by or dreamed of them.
In the ballet, The Rite of Spring by Igor Stravinsky, the unique tone color of the bassoon, straining at the top of its register, helps to suggest the awakening of nature.
Electronic instruments have also added new tonal dimensions to modern music. The synthesizer provides sounds not produced by traditional instruments or voice. A composer can experiment with these new sounds and write music based on them instead of adapting to the instrumentation of a band or orchestra. George Crumb uses some unusual sound sources in his song cycle, Ancient Voices of Children. The toy piano, musical saw, harmonica, mandolin, Tibetan prayer stone, Japanese temple bells, and electric piano are used to achieve special instrumental effects.
We have seen how music can serve many purposes. It can convey a variety of emotions.
It can tell a story in one or many movements.
Or it can depict a scene.
Often, specific instruments are used to create special effects or special moods. Now, the language of music has been enriched through the use of electronic sounds. Music is everywhere.
Part C, Music Throughout the World. People around the world express their unique cultural traditions through music, song, dance, and distinctive musical instruments. Their folk rhythms and melodies tell us about their character, hopes, and feelings as a community.
The importance of music in religion, work, and social life has been evident since early times. From cave drawings thousands of years old, we know that early people played instruments and made music.
The traditional music we think of as characteristic of a particular place or people has usually been passed from generation to generation. Traditional music has also been integrated into the classical music of a country. Béla Bartók, Franz Liszt, and Antonín Dvořák are some of the composers who have used folk melodies in their works. Yet we often find a similarity that spans national boundaries in the themes or forms of folk music.
Folk music of a country or community is frequently linked to ceremonial occasions or celebrations.
Native American music often celebrates some element of nature, such as raising crops, birds, sunrise, and moonlight. Or it may be related to such ceremonial occasions as warriors celebrating victory over their enemies. The dances or chants of Native Americans are frequently accompanied by drums or rattles. Listen to this song by Hopi people. It is part of a ritual related to the arrival of spirits who bring rain.
Tribes in Africa, music provides entertainment and accompanies activities such as hunting and fishing. But it is also thought to chase away evil spirits and cure sickness. African tribesmen, like Native Americans, use drums and rattles to accompany their rhythms and dances, as well as to talk or communicate between villages. We can hear these traditional instruments in the popular African music of today. Listen to the drum rhythms played by musicians at a modern-day concert.
Ties are also evident among African, Caribbean, and South American music.
The steel drum, made from old steel barrels, and the rattle, called a maraca, are often used by calypso bands in this part of the world. Listen to the distinctive sounds of klezmer music. Eastern European Jews have used this form of music for centuries to express their emotions and customs.
Yet it also echoes the folk tunes and dances of countries such as Russia, Poland, and Romania.
Traveling bands of musicians known as klezmorim would perform on a variety of instruments that usually included the violin, clarinet, bass, and saxophone.
Klezmer music was transported to America by immigrant Jews during the 19th century. Later generations have stirred renewed interest in this music.
Gypsy folk music has its own special style, though it too draws on the ethnic music of many areas. Russia, Romania, Hungary, Bohemia, and Italy. It also blends Asian musical traditions with those of Western countries. Gypsies originally came from India, and their scales and rhythms are Eastern.
But real gypsy music, with its own exceptional stamp, is reflected in how the music is played and interpreted.
To the gypsy, the principal instrument of expression is the violin. We are listening to a gypsy band playing a Hungarian song.
Folk music clearly shows many similarities all throughout Eastern Europe. Listen to this typical folk music from Czechoslovakia and think of how much it resembles the music you have just heard. Now listen to this dance tune from Belarus.
Physical surroundings or geography also play a role in the traditional music of a country.
In Finland, music and song reflect the striking beauty of the land, as well as its relative isolation.
Folk music here is more likely to be about spiritual or epic tales or entertainment like sleighing, rather than about war and warriors. A primitive but popular instrument, the kantele, often accompanies folk music in Finland. It is a lap-held string instrument that has been used for 2,000 years.
You are listening to a traditional folk melody played on the kantele.
Thank you. flamenco quickly brings to mind a picture of Spain. This fiery music mirrors the warm climate and stormy history of the country. Can you feel the emotion of this music in the exaggerated rhythms of the guitars and the castanets of these flamenco dancers? Strong bonds linking the music of many Asian cultures. Music is quite frequently mystical or ritual in content or form.
In India, music is based on a series of rhythm and melody patterns called ragas. These determine the character of a work.
Ragas cover a vast range of concepts, such as love, anger, heroism, pity, joy, calm, wonder, or violence. Because little Indian music is written down, musicians improvise and provide their own musical interpretations.
The basic musical group here is a small ensemble of a few string and percussion instruments.
The sitar, with six or seven main playing strings, is the most popular instrument. Listen to this love song in which a young man compares his sweetheart to the beauty of nature.
In China, music is meant to provide a balance between heaven, or the spiritual, and earth.
The main elements of this music are melody and timbre rather than harmony, and many different musical instruments are used, including gongs, chimes, percussion, and flutes. In this typical piece from Shantung Province in China, a bamboo flute is accompanied by other Chinese instruments. The steady rhythm is maintained by beating on a wood block.
Chinese and Indian cultures and religions have influenced the traditional music of Indonesia. Yet this music has its own unique quality, which rests on an original scale system and the instruments that are used. In Indonesia, two basic scale systems determine the nature of a work. One is considered feminine and the other masculine. Music in Indonesia is often performed by an orchestra of instruments known as the gamelan. Largely percussion instruments with a limited range of tones, they are a mix of bells, gongs, chimes, and drums.
Japanese music has strong ties to the music of India and China, yet it has distinct features of its own. There is a clear separation between the ritual music of the court and ordinary festival or secular music.
Japanese music draws on a variety of percussion, reed, and string instruments. In this piece, we hear the haunting sound of the shakuhachi, a bamboo flute first developed in the 18th century.
Koto and samisen are two popular Japanese string instruments used in secular music. This samisen player and singer are accompanying a performance by puppeteers.
Of music as a national expression is universal. We have also seen that connections often link music from different countries.
The classical work, The New World Symphony by the Czech composer Antonín Dvořák, typifies these bonds. It evokes a picture of the immigration of many cultures to the United States and brings together concepts of classical music and traditional folk music. ¶¶